You are looking at the guardians of Israel's waters.
My name is India, and today we are going on patrol with Israel's Marine Police.
Israel has several Marine Police units strategically located across the country, each tasked with a range of critical responsibilities. From enforcing maritime law to conducting search and rescue operations, these units play a crucial role in Israel's coastal defense, serving as the second line of defense after the Israeli Navy. Today, we are in Ashkelon, a city not far from the Gaza Strip, to meet some of the Marine Police officers. But what makes them different than other police?
The main mission of the Marine Police is saving lives. First of all, we are warriors. Second of all, we are policemen. And third of all, and maybe most important, we are men of sea.
Due to their proximity to an active military zone, the officers face the possibility of numerous threats, such as rocket attacks from Gaza and strikes by anti-tank missiles. You see, the Ashkelon Marine Police are responsible for the waters of Palmachim Beach, south of Tel Aviv, to Zikim Beach, near the Gaza border. These waters, known as territorial waters, fall under full national jurisdiction, meaning the country's laws apply to any vessel within this zone. And just around where we are now, you can see the Navy in the distance. As we filmed, the sounds of large explosions coming from the Gaza Strip reminded us of the ongoing conflict that began on October 7th.
Can we talk about this beach here?
Zikim.
כרגע, במהלך המלחמה, חוף זיקים לא יכולים להגיע אליו אזרחים, הוא שטח צבאי סגור. לפני השביעי באוקטובר, החוף הזה היה שוקק. היו בו המון ישראלים מתרחצים, הוא חוף יפהפה. הוא החוף הכי דרומי במדינת ישראל.
However, not too long ago, on Zikim Beach, a terrible tragedy occurred. On October 7th, 30-year-old Mor Gabay was enjoying her morning on Zikim Beach with her friends. Suddenly, a group of Hamas terrorists on boats invaded the beach to take over an IDF training base. At first, no one realized they were in fact terrorists. The Israeli Navy blocked most of the landings, but about 11 terrorists reached the shore. They murdered Mor and around 18 other beachgoers, including fishermen and teenagers. But now, as before the war, the Marine Police continued to patrol the waters day and night, always on alert, ready to rescue anyone who may need their help.
במהלך השירות היו לנו אין ספור אירועים של הצלת חיים. היחידה הזאת במהלך השנים הצילה, אפשר להגיד, מאות אנשים, אולי אפילו אלפים. אתה יכול להיות בבסיס ואז אתה מקבל אירוע של אנשים שטובים או אנשים שנעדרים מכלי שיט. אנחנו פשוט רצים לכלים שלנו, עולים עליהם, מגיעים, מחפשים. הרבה פעמים הצלנו נערות ונערים שנייה לפני שהם נכנסים לתוך המים והרמנו אותם ממש מהשערות.
So if you are hoping to visit Israel's beaches this summer or in the future, keep this in mind.
We protect anybody that needs our help. That's the main goal. When we wake up in the morning and we put on this uniform and we go out, we know that we're going to encounter somebody who's facing their worst day. And that's where we're coming in. And we're dealing with them with sensitivity, with patience. It's not always easy. Sometimes they're dealing with terror. Sometimes they're dealing with crime. Or like you saw, sometimes out in the ocean, maybe they drifted away, maybe their boat flipped over. We're gonna be here for them to bring them to safety. Our officers aren't looking at backgrounds. They're not looking at genders or age or anything like that. Even in our own forces, we have officers that are Muslims, that are Christians. It doesn't matter.
These are Israel's Marine Police.
לכולם אני רציתי להגיד תודה רבה להכל שאתם עושים. עם ישראל חי.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.